Joining me here in the roundtable, political analyst and Georgetown University professor, and his dressing has drastically improved since Washington Watches come on the air, Dr. Chris Metzler. Angela Rod, co-founder and principal at Impact Strategies. Charles Lohler, Maryland State Director of Americans for Prosperity with that boy in white pocket square. And George Curry, syndicated columnist for the National Newspaper Publishers Association. And Charles, you're a newbie here, and so the first time. And do understand on this show, the white pocket square a little bored on this show. As other Sunday morning news shows, this is TV One, Washington Watch, a lot more color and flavor here. So next time you come on, lose the white pocket square. All right, let's get right into it. The panel we just finished talking to, we were dealing with this whole issue of black turnout in 2012. Significant numbers in terms of surpassing white folks who voted in 2012 as well. Now, what's interesting to me, folks are saying, well, what's going to happen in 16? And the reality is President Obama's not going to be on the ballot in 2016. So what does this say for the future for African-Americans when you look at the turnout in 12, but also 08?
A couple of things. One is we've been talking about it ad nauseum, but the GOP has an outreach plan they've put together that's going to cost in excess of $11 million. Needless to say, the Democrats will also have to put forth some realistic outreach plan to ensure that African-Americans continue to vote in large numbers. I think it wasn't just the fact that the president was on the ballot. It was also the fact that in several states throughout the country, there were these egregious voter suppression laws that we saw in several state legislatures, throughout several state legislatures. And as a result, we have in our history and in our culture the desire to want to fight back against something.
Right. And we heard a whole lot of that in 2012, but that hasn't stopped because even though Republicans will admit, we kind of screwed up with the voters, but those pieces, look what's happened in North Carolina right now.
Sure.
So look what happened in Arkansas passing a voter ID law. Governor said, I'm vetoing it. They overrode his veto. So it's not as if Republican legislatures have stopped passing such laws.
Sure.
But the question is, will black folks be as aggressive in turning out in the future elections?
I think so. And I think you don't just look at Obama years. You look at the last five presidential elections. Mm-hmm. You see the numbers been going up. And you also see the white share decreasing. And you're going to continue to see that. But you still don't see the Hispanic part. You see the numbers, but you don't see the voting reflected the same way. So that, to me, says we still have an enormous clout.
But Charles and Chris, if you're Republican, you can say, look what happened in 2010 midterms. And so the issue for me is not what happens in presidential years. For me, this is saying to black folks, you have shown your power, so why in the hell you can't do it in midterm years, in school board races, city council races, state rep, state senate races, where all of those positions matter as well.
Right. I think even more so, and first as a newbie, let me thank you so much for the opportunity to grace your presence. But I think even more so than that, we're seeing a transition. We really are, specifically in black America. Not just much more of an intelligent awakening of the voting power and the voting strength, all the things that our past founding fathers like Martin Luther King and others have stated about having that right and freedom to vote, but much more of an intellectual voters coming forward. I can see more and more both on the Republican and Democrat and quite frankly independent side where black America, they're going to vote. They're going to vote strong, and it's going to be a much more educated vote that is much more concerned about taxes. They are much more concerned about the economics in their community and how to get elected and change that culture. We're going to see that more and more and more and more, and I think that's a great thing,
George,
across the board.
What do you mean more educated vote? I don't understand that. Hold on. Time out. As though we've not been educated. We understand.
I didn't interrupt you. I'm going to finish my point.
I'm going to make my point. We've been very educated all along. We wish we had a viable option. There is no viable option out there when it comes to issues affecting African Americans.
Yeah, and I just want to make sure that we're clear. Not to harp on this, but let's not mislead. I'm not talking about the fact that we as African Americans aren't intelligent. We are intelligent. But when we talk about the going through the who's on the ballot, who can actually make change in our communities, because you're right, in some regards, we haven't had a real clear choice. That's why in many occasions, we flipped to the Democrat Party. We're seeing more and more black Americans become more and more independent in their politics. They're not even playing the political game. They're going to, when I say a much more intellectual voter, I mean across the board, we're going to weigh our options. Who's Democrat? Who's independent? Who's Republican? And here's the bottom line. What are they doing for my community?
Okay,
how is my community going to be better?
Angela and Chris.
So Democrats and black Democrats, or since you're saying that they've switched from the Republican Party, which I've not seen any data on, but what I will ask is this. How do you explain the 90 percent plus vote that the president got that is African American. If they're switching from Republican independent to vote for the president, or are you saying they're switching?
What I am saying clearly. Let me answer the first question. Absolutely, came out 90% numbers to vote for the president, President Barack Obama, for many obvious reasons. A wonderful opportunity. So many things changed when this gentleman entered into the White House, and so many stereotypes were broken down. I mean, we can talk that game all day, and we'll actually end up on the same side of the road. But when I talk about in transitioning, what I'm seeing, especially in Maryland, in Prince George's County, in Baltimore City, is many more African Americans saying, you know what, I'm not necessarily tied to a party. You're not going to take my vote for granted. I'm going to look at the entire
First of all,
it is true that when you look at the Joint Center for Political Economic Studies, they've done this analysis where an increasing number of African Americans are not self-identifying as Democrats or as Republicans, but when it is time to vote, Chris, they are making decisions saying who is speaking to the issues I am concerned about. And the reality is Republicans have ignored African Americans, ignored those issues. And so those folks say, I might have even given you a shot.
Absolutely.
But since you didn't even talk to me, you won't even get my vote.
Yeah. So I think I think it is, in fact, identification, and I think it's issues based. And the other thing is, to this point of this $11 million investment that the Republican Party has made, it's a joke. When you look at the total of $11 million and how much of that actually is going to be spent on outreach. And as a matter of fact, as Republicans, we have to go back to what the message is. I don't care if you have $11 million. You have $11 million without a message. Right. And what is that going to give you?
Right.
Zero.
Right.
The numbers are not going to move.
But George, I got to throw out, though, how do we get black folks to understand that if you did it in 08, and if you did it in 12, you can also do it in gubernatorial races, state races, DA races, judges, because we can't talk about a criminal justice system and ignore that we're voting for DAs and judges.
Yeah. No, I totally agree with you, but the problem we have is larger than that. It's not just African Americans, it's America, period.
No.
Yeah.
I don't care about everybody else. No, because I'm saying, if you look at our voting numbers, and if you look at any of these various states where we have significant, Georgia, some 800,000 African Americans who are unregistered. So the point I'm making is, if white folks keep voting the same way they'll vote, getting African Americans to understand we could flip many races on state and local level if we're voting our numbers.
Yeah, and I totally agree. And that means we have to do a better job of tying that together, because really it have more of an impact on the local level than you do on the national level on a large extent. But I don't want to go past Chris' point. I totally agree with Chris on that. But the problem fundamentally is not how much money you spend on outreach. The problem is your record. If you look at the NAACP report card, and every Republican got an F. Everyone. And so you can have all the outreach you want. If you're not voting in concert with what African Americans could perceive to be their best interest, you're going to lose.
Well, hold tight, because I'm not getting an F in paying bills. Be back in 1 second.